Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello students, today we are studying chapter photosynthesis. In that we'll be studying today is what are basically camp plants. Now there are certain plants in desert or desertic plants where temperature is really high, and these plants follow some other pathway, which is crassus acid metabolism or camp pathway. Today we'll be studying how desert plants do camp pathway. Camp pathway. We all know that desertic plants or xerophytic plants which grow in desert have to undergo a lot of sun heat. Desert has huge amount of sun, or the temperature is really high. Now during this phenomena, or due to this phenomena, you can say the stomata has to be closed during daytime. We all know that the plant doesn't want to lose water when it is present in desert. If it will lose all its water due to transpiration, that is loss of water, when the stomata opens during daytime, the plant will die eventually, or the plant will be in great loss. So what desertic plants do is they close their stomata during daytime to avoid loss of water. Now if stomata is closed during daytime, don't you all think so that carbon dioxide or water molecules, how are they going to enter into the leaf or a chlorophyll, and how does the process of photosynthesis take place in daytime? Yes, the answer is camp pathway or crassus acid metabolism. What happens in camp pathway is the stomata of desertic plants, which is closed during daytime, opens at night time, and the cycle of camp pathway takes place at night time using certain molecules. Camp pathway was basically first discovered into bryophyllum plants.
मैडम जो आपने पूछ लिया ना फिर स्क्रीन में आ गया चलो कट हो जाएगा नहीं इधर रख सकते मैडम उठाया था ना आपने
हाँ
तो स्क्रीन में आ गया
ओके अब ठीक
है ओके
Camp pathway was first observed into bryophyllum, a member, and during camp pathway carbon dioxide is fixed, but during night time, and once carbon dioxide is fixed in night time, the stable product which is obtained in camp pathway is further passed down to C3 cycle in daytime. So let us see how camp pathway actually works and how desertic plants prepare their food or do photosynthesis. Camp plants or desertic plants. Basically, camp pathway is also called as crassus acid metabolism and was first observed in bryophyllum leaves. Now, camp pathway is an alternate for C3 pathway or Kelvin cycle, Blackman's reaction, any of those. In certain plants, C3 pathway takes place, whereas in desertic plants, C4 pathway takes place. So, if I talk about millets, or you can say ragi, nachni, the pathway that takes place is C3 pathway, whereas desertic plants, cactus, do C4 pathway, or you can say camp pathway. This occurs in desertic plants, xerophytic plants. The reasons for camp pathway occurrence is that stomata, the openings present in the leaf of a plant, are closed at daytime to avoid loss of water due to transpiration. And at night time, the stomata open so that the plant can fix carbon dioxide. camp plants, there are no crayons anatomy, means there will be no bundle sheath cells. And if there are no bundle sheath cells, obviously RUBB won't be present, one. Second, pep carboxylase will not be present. And we all know pep carboxylase has affinity to absorb carbon dioxide less than 50 ppm. So the first stable product that is formed during this cycle is malic acid, that is formed in night time. And at night time, malic acid is stored, and when one sun comes, malic acid is transported, and this malic acid is converted into carbon dioxide and pyruvic acid, that is daytime. Now pyruvic acid is a stable 3-carbon compound, whereas the carbon dioxide that is formed during this process is taken back, or it is deported to Kelvin cycle or C3 cycle, and now the Kelvin cycle will start. So in this camp plant pathway, we have seen that C4 plants, due to the closure of stomata at night time, follow the camp pathway or C4 plants. And once carbon dioxide is formed, again Kelvin cycle starts to appear. So basically, see, in desertic plants, the camp pathway as well as the C3 cycle are being used. Students, in this part of the chapter, we have studied about how crescens acid metabolism or camp pathway functions, and what are the various parameters on which it subsides or residues. I hope you all are clear with the concept of camp pathway. Thank you.